Alright guys, we're going to do a boneless ribeye today. So when you open the bag, don't use your knife, use the back. Okay? Rip it open. Now when you open it up, best way to do it, leave the bag underneath so it collects all the blood for you. Alright, now you have your rib here. Give it a little wipe down so you're not slipping all around on it. We're going to take it to the saw real quick. We're just going to clean up the edges of the bones. A little bit off the top. Now the easiest way to do it before you remove the ribs is clean off the bottom part. Now this is all good trim. You can throw that right in the mincer. Alright, the ribs. Take a hook. If you don't have a hook, you can use pretty much anything to get under that rib. You should be able to pull the membrane right off. Now on this side, get the little flap there. Just work your fingers under it. Take it right off. Alright, time to remove the ribs. Always start at the small end. You want to work with an upside down grip. You can do overhand as well if you're more comfortable with that. And just working your way against the bones. Alright, when you're at that stage, just clear the rib right off. There you are, you got your boneless roast. Clean it up just a little bit. And this meat as well. Great for mincing. Alright. So here we are. Now you can see there's a big chunk of fat. If you want to retail this as a full roast, best way to do it, pull it right back, rip it with your Hulk strength. You don't want to take it off. You'll see right in here, there's still a lot of good meat. So what you want to do is you want to cut it at an angle. Now you can just clean up this section right here. Alright, now you got your boneless rib. Now this is the part where you decide if you want to add some fat to it. You want to keep it regular. And basically from here, you just tie it up. Starting at the middle. Thank you. Alright guys, so here you go. All tied up, ready to go. Now if you're going to put this in a butcher counter, you want to make it look really pretty, you just square up the ends. And that's great trim too. You have a nice flat end for the customer to see. You also got a nice rack of ribs, which is a good treat for yourself or if you're selling the roast, for the customers as well.